Hello everyone, today we're going to talk about Substance Painter, an alternative to Blender. Many people ask about it in the comments, so I will cover it today. We're going to skin the Boxer MGS. Substance Painter costs 600 euros a year or 200 euros for lifetime license on Steam. You can also get a 1 year free license. I will put the guide how to do that below. You need to apply for a license and within 3 days you get a license. But you can also use the Blender tutorial, which is fully free. I will link that in the info card at the top of the screen. I personally prefer Blender over Substance Painter, but that's just personal preference. To start skinning the Boxer MGS, we first need to download the object file. You need to go to gamemodels3d.com and buy an account or go into my Discord server and ask for the files. Many people provide the files for free there. Then you need to download the object. Then you need to open it. It goes to the second screen. Then we will export it out of the zip file. Then we can close this. Then we have to open Blender because we need to fix the UV maps because they are broken standardly, sadly. Import file, import object files, downloads. Then I need to scroll, there it is. The issue what we have is like the hull, for example, if I will edit this full selecting UV maps, you will notice the UV map is below the skin. To fix that, we need to move it over. How to easily do that is select everything besides the lamp and press Ctrl J on the keyboard, so it will become one. Then you go to UV editing. You will select everything. And then we will select everything right here. And press this tool so you can move it up. And then you move it into the right position. You will try to do this as precise as possible. Like mine needs to be up a little. This is perfect. When you have this done, you go to File, Export, FBX, and then you export the FBX file as a Boxer into a folder to your choosing. When we've done that, we're gonna open Substance Painter. When Substance Painter is over, go to File, New, File Select, Boxer FBX. Then you will put the resolution of 4K, because that's a standard skinning resolution. Then you will turn OpenGL, this can all be off, that's all fine. Then we go start it. And then you will see you have the Boxer right here. To move around it, you hold Alt and use the mouse keys to move. Like the left mouse is turning, right mouse is to left and right, and the other is zoom. The right mouse button is zoom, and middle is to left to right. Next up, we're gonna see where the hull is. You have here a list of different things like the gun, the turret, everything. And we're gonna look for the hull. Let's see, this is not the hull, this is not the hull, this is not the hull. That's our antennas. I will make it a little bigger. Some do everything, absolutely nothing, but we will look for the hull. This is the hull right here. I will rename it, double press it and rename it to your choosing. I will name it just the hull, because it is the hull, so lekker easy. Now we have this, you can already paint on it, if you see. I am a bit goofy today. You can paint on it already. But we now will go back to where we started in the downloads folder. go to textures we exported from the zip file, and you will notice to the hull you have the AO, the C, and the NN. When you have found those three files, press the C file and drag it into Substance Painter and put it here in the layers menu. Then you get this menu and press base color. You will see it's now is the War Thunder camouflage. Now we will go back, fill the AO file, drag the Substance Painter, same spot, and this is the roughness. Now we will go back again for the N file, that's the last file, go back to Substance Painter, drag below it, and do height. No, normal, excuse. And then you have everything ready and you have the War Thunder aesthetic. Now we have this, you can paint on it like you want to do. You can press the paintbrush, paint on the vehicle. What I will do is make a paint layer. You can paint all over it, everywhere you want. You can drag around, paint all over it. That's everything is fine. You can also just fill the entire thing in with the color you like. You can go here to base color, press the color, and you can select color, for like reddish. I will use this black. Now with the color, we can work on the decals. For the decals, I'm gonna go to Photoshop. And then I'm gonna go back to here. And I'm gonna take the decal I want. And I drag it into Photoshop. And make sure it's a square canvas. Otherwise, make a square canvas of it. Put it in a square canvas. What we're gonna do now is make a new layer below it. Make it on fully black. Now you have like this. First off, you will export without the black, so just the regular decal. Or if it's already square, you don't have to re-export it, but not the PDF. I will do it decal. And now we're gonna make it black. And what I'm gonna do is make this fully white. This will be the alpha of the decal. So we're gonna export this. Decal. Alpha, export. Now we have the alpha and the color, we're gonna go back to Substance Painter. We're gonna make a new painting layer. Now we're gonna look down until we find the base color. Then we're gonna go back here, get the colored version, drag it into there, make it the base color, so you see this. Then we go to alpha, right here. You're gonna get the alpha variant. Drag it also into there. And now, if I'm correct, you will have a brush, which make decals. So for example, what we're gonna do now is, let's see, nice spot right here. Here you can put the decal with the stencil. And you can put them everywhere you want. You can also just brush with it. I don't know why you want to do that, but you can. And now you can place the decals. And you do this again with every decal you like. And then you have in the end a vehicle ready that you can export. The alpha isn't always necessary. Like you can see here, I have the silhouette of the decal. But if I do this away, that there is no alpha. I can also place it with just a round circle. Only it's less precise. As an alternative, you can use projection decal. You do that to go to the file again, find the decal, drag it into Substance Painter, and place it over the part you want to put it on, and that loose. Then you get this menu, mask, base color, height, metallic, blah blah, and you select base color. Then you have a projection decal. You can size it up. I will size it down a bit. And then you can drag it around. The benefit of a projection decal is that you can move it around. Even after you're done with it and placed it and go back to something else. You can come back to the decal and still move it around to adjust it. It's not as permanent as a normal decal would. Next up, When your skin is entirely done, you put all the decals in, you paint it all the camouflage, like I don't know, just a nice color, red, you painted camouflage in. Nice blocky. When you painted the entire vehicle, have the camouflage ready, you can go to File, Export. You see here the output coordinates. In my case, it goes into the OneDrive. And you click Export. When it's done, you go to the location it was put in. It will have a lot of files, but the most aren't necessary to us. If you found all the files you need, you can remove all the other ones. Like this one, we overall don't need, because we're only painting the hull, we're not doing anything with the normals. We're not doing anything with the antennas, we don't do anything with the rest of it. So yeah, we can all go away. When you have the one you need, we're gonna go to Asset Viewer, which always takes a while to boot up. Then you go look up for the vehicle you want. I need the boxer, I need the C file, the body C. So the body color file. I will export it to the same folder as the other files in. So when I go back there too, then you take the DDS file we just exported, put it in Photoshop. Then you will go back, get the other color file, put it in Photoshop. Then you will put a mask on this, a mask will appear in channels. Then you will copy the alpha. And then we will put the alpha and this one down. Now you have the version with Gaijin's weathering, so the standard weathering on all vehicles from Gaijin itself. You can go to File, Save as Copy, DDS, take this one, that the name is the same. Press opslaan. And then the file is done. Press op alpha channel none. DTX5. Mipmap can be off. Now we have this finished and saved. We can go back and you see that the skin file is done. What we can do now is go to WarThunder. When you're into WarThunder, you can go to the vehicle you're skinning. Press customize. And then user skin disabled, make user skin. So you get this. What you then will do is go to your user skin folder on, fuck, I have a shortcut on my drive. Then you will see here, then you can go to the DDS we saved, copy it, Ctrl C, Ctrl V. We don't need the TGA files. Then you open the BLK. Then you copy the name, the full name you saved it as. Then you will look for the body, boxer, crocodile, body TGA. And then you will replace this with the name of the file. So CDDS. When you go back into WarThunder, you see the skin here. And you will see the skin worked and is exported into the vehicle as expected. These are just the basics what you can do with Substance Painter and WarThunder user skinning. I personally prefer Blender, but this is also a great alternative if you have a lot more cash to play around with or have the free subscription of a year. You can do a lot with it, also weldings and all kind of stuff, but that's more in-depth. I will put some links in the description to more in-depth tutorials about Substance Painter. But this is just how can I skin WarThunder vehicles in Substance Painter and not necessarily how works Substance Painter, as there are many tutorials about that. I hope you guys enjoyed. See you next time and goodbye.